Welcome back to our Proactive Newsroom, and I'm talking to Faron Pharmaceuticals this morning. We've got the CEO, Markku Jalkanen, and the CFO, James O'Brien, on the line. Firstly, a very warm welcome to you both. And secondly, I'm going to jump straight in with a question for you, Markku. You released those interim results yesterday for the 6 months to the 30th of June this year. Perhaps you can tell us about the highlights.
Yeah, and we are extremely excited. You may recall that we started a study called BEXMAB roughly a year ago. And it's really targeting the acute myeloid leukemia patients who have very few options at the moment to be really get rid of the disease. We earlier had already published initial readout, which really indicated that, yes, we really can kill the cancer cells from those patients, and they really reach a complete remission with a very great number as well. So now we went up to the highest aimed concentration, that is 6 mg/kg, and had the first readout. What we saw in that readout is that we reached this benefit already sooner than previously, and it goes immediately to the complete remission. So out of the 5 patients in that cohort, 3 of already responded, and one of them already really also re-established the blood content to the very close to the normal. So it's really a complete remission in all the different analyses. And 2 of them, the 4th and the 5th, are stabilized conditions, so it can even continue further on. So this means that we really have maybe now optimized the dosing, and we are ready to move on to the phase 2 part, which is then aiming at quarter 4. Very exciting results for the condition where there are very few options for the patients. And it all makes really sense if you think about it, the twofold mode of action, what bexmarilimab has on these cancer cells. First, we activate the patient's immune system, and then we target the cancer cells, and they lose their viability. Perfect design for this condition.
Thanks, Markku. And there was some big news by coincidence just yesterday on the same day as the interims from the FDA about bexmarilimab, wasn't there?
That is absolutely true. And we have indicated that we have ongoing discussions with the regulators, and this is now first outcome of those discussions. So it's an orphan status that would really accelerate the interactions with the regulators, and there are some other benefits as well. And obviously, when we have said that we are aiming to get a biological license application, BLA, filed in 25, these are the important regulatory steps along this development we do with drug itself.
Thank you very much, Markku. So one of the other obvious highlights from the first half was the appointment of yourself, James O'Brien. You are the CFO now, and it has been a busy period for the company, including 2 placements. So tell us about your experience of that first half.
Yeah, thank you. So the company has been very fortunate. Our shareholder base has supported us to raise over 18 million euros so far this year. We entered the third quarter with over 12.8 million euros of cash to fund the operations to the end of the year. So we're very delighted about where we are today, the clinical development program that we have for Bex, and to be able to support it via our finances.
All understood. Thank you. And how do you feel in terms of the runway at the moment? What does it look like?
It looks like it's through the end of this year, through the end of 23. We have a number of opportunities to extend that runway with a number of the business development opportunities that we're working on today. But again, we have a very supportive shareholder base. We're a very capital efficient organization, which is good.
Thank you very much, James. And one final question for you, Markku. We were just hearing about the business development opportunities. That was one of the reasons for a change in the composition of your board during the first half. Somebody stepped down to focus on biz dev, and you made some additions to the team there as well. So what else do you think we can expect from the business during that second half?
Well, that's a really good point. And obviously, target is really to have some kind of a larger resources really around the bexmarilimab, including the effort really to come to the market. You know, there are a lot of activities you have to do prior getting there. And obviously, now when we have been talking to the various entities over the last 2 years or so, those are now intensifying. And that was the reason also why Leopold stepped down from the board. He is really an experienced person in life science industry and knows rather well how you structure optimal deals for the biotechs. So that was a good addition for our business development team, and that's an ongoing project at the moment. We are very, very excited about that opportunity as well.
Very glad to hear it. And let me wish you both the very best of luck. And we'll catch you again very soon here on Proactive.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.